A local hospital is now taking drastic measures to fight obesity.
KMBC 9's David Hall joins us live with the initiative that Children's Mercy Hospital is starting up to keep you healthier and safer. David?
That's right. Good evening. It's called Feel Better, Feel Better, and it started with the Children's Mercy Employee Wellness Committee looking to expand a healthy lifestyle for all. So we're talking about no more sugary drinks and healthier food options.
So if you were drinking a 20-ounce Coke like this, you would get about a little more than this amount of sugar.
Children's Mercy Hospital Weight and Management Coordinator Shelley Summer says thanks to the Feel Better, Feel Better program, some sugar drinks won't be sold at this hospital starting in January. The hospital will only serve diet sodas and 100% juices that have no added sugars.
We're doing it because we think it's the right thing to do.
Other changes already in effect include ads promoting healthy foods. Summer says in 2011, 34% of 13,000 patients seen were overweight or obese.
What we're seeing are the medical complications that are a result of kids being overweight or obese. We're seeing kids at younger and younger ages with high blood pressure, with insulin resistance, with type 2 diabetes. They're beginning to see a fatty liver disease, which over a long period of time develops into very serious medical complications.
Some might question, why did it take so long for this change?
I think change is a hard thing. And I think getting enough support to be able to move forward and make that change and to have it be successful and have people support you is a challenge.
A challenge that one local mother is happy to see being faced.
I would consider it a passionate investment towards the health of my child.
At least one healthy meal will now be offered in the cafeteria, and now fruit and vegetable dollar purchases equal 10% or more of total food purchases, and more healthy changes will be coming in the very near future. Reporting live from David Hall, KMBC 9 News.
Thank you, David. This initiative will take full effect by the year 2015. And just in case you're wondering, Truman Hospital was the first hospital in the area to stop selling sugary drinks in its cafeteria.